Hey, good morning, fellow nurses. Good morning, Nigerians. It is another bright Monday morning, and I hope you guys had a great weekend. How are you fighting the COVID-19? Hoping that you are all staying safe and secure wherever you are. Well, in a pandemic that has become a thing of ridicule in Nigeria, it looks like the whole thing has been reduced to a joke. Well, that is what you got. Well, I hope you guys are doing well. It's another episode of the Nurses Arise program on the Nightingale Radio station, broadcasting live from Houston, Texas, United States of America. You know how we do it. Monday morning, 6 a.m., we do our live broadcast. And at 6 p.m., we do a repeat broadcast of what was done in the morning for those for the benefit of those who missed our morning edition. Yes, you know, Nigeria has so much on its plate. Citizens are scraping life for survival, betrayers, threats, and all kinds of things. The country is in disarray. Tragic failure of leadership at all levels and in all sectors. All sectors of Nigeria, what can we do as citizens? Are we going to resign to fate? Are we going to keep quiet? Our backs are on the wall. In fact, very soon we'll be finding a way to evaporate inside the wall, you know, in our attempt to shy away from our responsibilities of standing tall and firm against those who oppress us every day. Well, those who are scared, there will be no reprieve, because the evil hands are all over the country. So the only thing now is the only thing Nigerians have left is to stand up and fight. There's nothing. God is not going to come down. Stop praying and making God look like he's an idiot. You got to stand up and fight. For the nurses of Nigeria, you have an uphill task ahead of you. We have pretended. You suffer in silence. But those who oppress you, those who exploit you, they have not gone to sleep. The only thing left for you now is to push back. And I don't think there's any moment as auspicious and as good as now than to start resisting those who have been oppressing you. Now I've come to discover the reason nurses are not able to fight causes in Nigeria. The problem is first within the nursing profession. You have a bankrupt leadership. Bankrupt leadership. There's now the whole thing that happens in the big mainstream Nigeria is in nursing. Surprisingly, a profession we see as immaculate. Everybody great. But I see you have a serious crisis. Crisis of leadership that scared the hell out of the practitioners. The reason why people are so scared for their lives, people are scared, they want to hold on to their jobs, and at the expense of the growth and development of their profession. The moment to rebel is now, and nobody is going to come and do it for you but yourselves. You know how you bring your leadership into power, and that you must devise a way. You must devise a way. You must change the ways, how you elect your leadership, how you choose those who lead you right from the unit level to the national level, is the bane of your pain and sorrows. Why should a few persons hold a whole profession in captivity in Nigeria? Listen carefully. You know what? Those who fight for nurses, those who fight for nurses are attacked by nurses. I now see the reason why not many people are ready to bring their faces in the struggle for the emancipation of the Nigerian nurses. That nurses have a violent gang, a cartel, what they call cabal in the bigger Nigeria. So the nursing profession is a microcosm of the corrupt and dysfunctional Nigeria. You know what? Bullies don't stop. The only people with the power to stop the bullies are the victims of the bullies. Nurses are bullied by everybody. And the worst type of bully that comes from that affects the nursing profession and nurses in Nigeria are the bullies from within the nursing profession. You know what? I was threatened. Since yesterday, I've been receiving death threats. Obviously, from some members of the leadership of nursing in Nigeria. Why? Because the message that I have been driving is getting to them. And they are sleepless and restless. They have become very uncomfortable with the message. Well, you know, when you deal with darkness, of course, you have to be prepared. I am not a stranger to being threatened. Bring it on, but be ready to deal with the consequences. I am a product of circumstance. The Nurses Arise program is a program of circumstance. If everything was great, there won't be any need for anybody to catalyze a rebellion within the nursing profession. It is because the drivers of the nursing profession are not doing what they are supposed to do. They are corrupt, they are morally bankrupt, they are vicious, they are vindictive, they are oppressive, they are repressive, they are everything evil to the nursing profession. They repress nurses, they oppress them, they scare the hell out of them and expect that they will be allowed to continue the way it has always been. No, the moment to stop it is now. Hey, if you are a nurse and you are bold, you want to contribute to this program, the number to call is 832-407-6282 Once again, 832-407-6282. The moment to conquer your fear is now. Look, look, I tell you this. These guys, they are criminals. They are bad, but they cannot do anything. The reason why they are able to do all they have been doing is because of the conspiracy of silence from among the nursing practitioners. If we all stand up and hold them down, that is the end of them. So let us bail the cat now. It can be costly, it's dangerous, but somebody has to lead it. They sent me a message. Leave me, get out of my back, get off of my business. You will be cremated. I wish this guy knew what he has just put himself into. Well, there's nothing anybody can do to intimidate me. There's nothing anybody can do to stop the revolution that is already taking place in the nursing profession. The only people who can stop themselves are the nurses of Nigeria. Well, they have a choice, either to get out of darkness or illuminate their darkness with light. The great thing is that we already know who you are, and you are on a radar. If you think you can hide behind a false profile with a white man and that you will not be identified, now you have hit the wrong button. We already know who you are. We know the clique. You have added yourself to the long list of those people on the radar. But one thing I promise you is this. Bring your hell on and see how disappointed you're going to get. Get ready The nurses of Nigeria, it is time for you to rise up from your sleepless slumber. I get pissed off when you call me from behind the scene to express that you are scared for your job. Well, life on its own is a risk. That you wake up in the morning and go to work on a road you don't even know who is going to be driving on the opposite side, it's a risk. So you got to wake up and do what you have to do.
Sir.
You got to wake up and save your profession. You got to wake up and save your dignity. You got to wake up and demand respect for yourself. You got to wake up and demand for transparency and accountability from those who lead you, those who collect your dues every month, to go to overseas trips for which they never account to you. You are not stupid. Yes, majority of you have been, would I say, ignorant, that you think because you have a job, they collect your dues. You must chase your money. Find out how are they using it to advance the cause of your profession. How are they using it to better the image of your profession? How are they using it to maintain standard or upgrade your profession? You see, you are one group of people that are victims of the system, victims of the people, victims of the conspiracy from within the healthcare delivery system, and sadly, victims of your own leadership. At what point are you going to start asking questions about the well-being of your profession? Hey, fellow nurses, this is Smart Madu Ajaja, the presenter of the Nurses Arise program on the Nightingale Radio Station. Worldwide broadcasting from Houston, Texas, United States of America. Yes, yesterday evening, I received a message from someone I don't know. I never have encountered the person, at least. I know it's a fake account. In the first place, with a white man's profile picture, and the number the person has on file was +316 352 59604. His opening message was, "Would you ever learn to stay away from my business?" Well, I said, "Who is this?" He didn't say who he was. And then he called my name, my full name, Madu Ajaja Madu. Now, saying, I won't be repeating myself. A word is enough for the wise. However, I know you are far from anything wise. Have a nice day. I said, okay, if you are not a coward, why didn't you show your face? Then he insulted my father. That's okay. I have told you, leave my business. Take care. I have warned you, the next time I speak to you on this same matter, someone is getting hurt. You are going to be the one getting hurt. Not a threat, though it's a promise. Well, said, don't insult me or you'll see death quicker than you thought. Be warned. Well, the discussion followed, and gradually I was able to get hold of whom I know, the source of the threat. He said he was going to cremate himself and not me, sending me all these calls of dangerous. He's a cultist, but you know what? I'm not scared of cultists. I stopped single-handedly 1985. Somebody from Aochi Polytechnic attempted to introduce cultism at my school, and I single-handedly stopped them. I warned those, some of my friends who were part of it. I said, okay, man, if you can't stop, then be ready to be expelled from the school. But I started seeing my friends, they started wearing black berets and started dressing some kind of funny ways. And I told them, you are nurses. Nurses are supposed to be clean and pure. You don't do shady things. You don't suck blood. You don't get becoming vampires. So you better send this thing, put an end to it. And I called a guy who came. He was rusticated for cultism at Aochi Polytechnic. Then he came to the School of Health Technology, Benin, and then wanted to continue with cultism and then spreading the evil of cultism among healthcare professionals. I called him. Pascal is his name. I said, you better put an end to this, or you'll be gone out of the school. Anyway, that's that. So, I am not new to some of all these things. You threaten me for doing the right thing, for telling the nurses of Nigeria to stand up and start demanding for accountability and transparency, and then start demanding anything, nothing short of the best from those who lead them at various levels, be it at the schools, the clinical areas, the regulatory agencies, and the trade union. Now, well, my involvement with all this, nurses are beginning to open their eyes. And the operators of darkness from within the nursing profession have gotten restless and sleepless. Now they have decided to go this dark way to attack me, thinking that that is going to put an end to the rebellion towards light. That is not going to happen. I am not the type of person anybody can silence. I have a mission, and my mission is driven by good. You can't kill light. You can't kill the truth. But before you get to me, you will find out. So I warn you. I'm not appealing to you. I warn you very sternly to beat a retreat. The message has gone everywhere already. Just advise yourself. Do the right thing for the nurses. Let us have a nursing profession that can compete with the best in the world. Fight for nurses. Put your name on the sands of time so that generations upon generations, will remember you as a star for nurses and the nursing profession. That is all my advocacy has been about. That is all my activism within the nursing profession has been about. So for you to wake up, perhaps on the wrong side of your bed, to start issuing me death threats, I don't know how consequence conscious you are of what you have just committed. You think that I am a pushover? You think I'm one of those nurses you can run over? You perhaps may have killed before, but there are some people that you cannot kill. So my friend, beat a retreat in your best interest. If you are one of the obstacles holding nurses in shackles, I break those shackles. I tell you, beat a retreat before it is too late for you. I came in peace. When I heard what I heard, I called the relevant people. Some insulted me. Some did not respond to my calls at all. And I think I have a right to explanations about what is taking place in my profession in Nigeria. Before some of you, I was a NAM official, and we did our jobs diligently for the nursing community in our unit, and they were happy with us. In fact, nurses were looking forward to being part of our NAM meetings. We never had any scanty house. Every day there was a NAM meeting, the attendance was unbelievable. The only people who could not attend immediately were those who were on duty. People will come from town to attend our meetings. But you guys have destroyed NAM. You guys have destroyed the nursing profession to the point that the nurses became uninterested in being part of whatever is taking place, regardless of the fact that you are collecting their monies to fund your nefarious activities. You go overseas trips on the money of nurses. You stay in big hotels on the back of the dues that nurses pay. You drive cars that you cannot afford on your own as an individual on the dues that you collect from nurses. But yet, you are not able to do anything to serve the interest of the nurses and the nursing profession in Nigeria. How sad you are, and you have the audacity to be issuing me threats and think that I will back down, that I'll be scared of you. You are a joke.
Thank you.
Yeah, hey, it's in a while. We don't open ID, so we go fit settle this matter, so nothing too hard for God to address. My brother is well with you, body and soul. Ah, man, amen, amen. Well, let me make I tell honor the truth. No, only we go fit solve this problem. Now, we. If we do what we're supposed to do, this problem go solve. Make anybody not fear for my life, because nobody will touch me. For real. So make one not fear. Waiting on I go do now this. Come together. Nurses, you don't tell. Now I cause this problem. Because when they keep quiet too much. Anywhere when they push on I go, on I go go. On another, they ask question. So now the thing when they happen. So as on another, they ask question now. These people go come get so much muscle when we say, you know, if you touch them, you know, if you do anything to them, they will do anything when they like. Now the thing. Now they come many years of our silence when we keep quiet, when nobody feed to everybody they fear. You they protect your job. You are more interested in protecting your job. But your job comes under an umbrella of a profession. That profession deserves your time. It deserves your love. If they close nursing profession, you're not going to get job again. So remember that. It be like a father, a mother. If you abandon your children, they will grow wild. And at the end of the day, who then will they blame? Say you not raise them well. Now you. So our profession need love. It need care. You need the better, good people to lead us. So it starts with you. It starts with how many times when they call NAM meeting for your unit when you go. When they call, you prefer to go to market, go APA, go buy your material. You not concern me, so far you get your work. Okay, year in, year out. Young house officers who don't know anything, they will come. You go train them, finish, they will come begin insult you. They will come begin slap you for inside word. They will come even earn more money than you. You don't date there 8 years. One small boy will come out from medical school. He don't know anything. Now you teach him how to take blood pressure. Now you teach him how to take a temperature. Once he don't learn, finish from you. Even if say you are not there the same profession, you become your competition. They treat you anyhow. And I go, they say, yes, sir, yes, doctor, yes, that. Now the thing. So any person, when they in a place, or you be village man, or you go village, you think, say, the people when they village, now farmers, oh, I not get any business to do with them. But now then they lead that community. Any law when them pass, any regulation when them put, it go concern you. It then go use and govern you. You go obey them. If you not obey, then go find you, or you go pay a price for it. The same thing, now they happen for nursing profession. If they call a nurses meeting, you find one thing, say, now they more important to you than that meeting. Any decision when they reach that for that meeting is binding on you. Now you go use work. You not go feel come from outside when they don't already decide. You say, man, they can't change them because of only you. Not lie. So, the important thing now, going forward, when they call now meeting, make sure, Unless say you're picking the sick, your husband the sick, or you have a serious family emergency, when go stop you, then that is understandable. Say now one thing, you want to do birthday, they do birthday party and all that, or they send a happy birthday, which you can always send. Say now others, you the gossip, now I make you not come go something as important as nurses meeting, where they go discuss how your profession go day better. Now problem you don't cause for yourself with that. Now so it they take grow. So when they call NAM meeting for like 100, 200 nurses, only 20 people show up. Now they think when that 20 people decide, 9 they will take work. So if among those 20 people, no good person there, they can say, okay, one share position. They will share them among themselves. Now wait on I see, 9 man I will take. So now how those people want lead? If they want chop all the money, one they contribute to, they will chop them. Yeah, you know, if you ask question, because when they hold the meeting, when they will make that kind of decision, you know they. Okay, now they remind on now election they come this time. And part of the problem when we get number one, for, before we talk about election, the constitution, when they guide nurses for now, the constitution not good. Even the Oyibo when they take right and from beginning to the end, not get ahead. If for BC, maybe he made them use a local dialect, you know, write them in Igbo, write them in Yoruba, write them in Hausa, and Edo, and all the language, so that people go feed it up. But if you carry that constitution, they read. If na person when no English, head they go, they worry you. From the beginning to the end. It not be like the thing when people won't go school. Right. And this is not profession when we get some professors. We get people and get PhD. We get people when they teach for school of nursing. We get those when they teach for university. This is not good. The time don't reach. Make we look our constitution. They say they write somebody rewrite the constitution, but it not involve all the nurses. Only a group of people in Cabal and then put together can write the constitution. So that one when they write, so now why you maybe they make it not good. So we go cancel that one when they say they amend. Make all nurses put head together, write a better constitution. Give them to the people who answer be right, not be anyhow person. Then go edit them, proofread it, then give it, then nurses go approve them. Say yes, this now our original standard document. When nurses for Nigeria, they take work. It go day better like that. Then another thing, when they inside, inside that constitution, the way one that they take choose leadership, not good. You not good. They say one that they use delegate. That delegate system not good at all. Delegate system, they cause what? They bring corruption. So the person when you choose, say, now go say speak for now, for there. When they are two, one I go say, okay, this one our delegate. They feed it there. Collect money from people. Do the same, do opposite of waiting on the send them. They go put them for inside big hotel when they never sleep for their life. When they not go even feel wake up, say, I want to go enter this hotel, pay for them. Because not be their money. I beg. The one when I they suggest, when go make sense. When be every nurse for Nigeria go vote. Put your vote. Don't put any delegate. Any person when they contest, like for presidency, you then bring 3 people. Okay, thank God. We get radio station now. Nightingale Radio Station will offer free debate for all the candidates when we run for NAM national president. Where all nurses go hear them speak. Waiting they won't do for nothing. How then go take do make nurses they get respect? How then go do make nurses get higher hazard allowance? Make the quality of education for nurses improve when they take and go university. So that all nurses, instead of going to school of nursing now university straight, university of nursing, or they upgrade all the schools of nursing to be awarding the university degrees. So there's a pathway, an academic pathway to being awarded a degree. Who go do it? how they go do them. They go explain the procedure when they get. If not four or three of them, everybody go talking own. How they go come, they say, okay, this money one that they contribute to NAM every month. This we go to show on every 3 months how we spend the money. So that on I go know how would they spend on our money. Now we say one person go just carry, you go Chicago. You go come back, stay in the best hotel, go to the shop, go to strip club on top of on our money. And on top of that, they will come back, they're not gonna account for anything. Abe, on a mumu, supposed to don't do now. So those people, when then they say them be cabal for inside nursing. Only me who are not going to break their back. But when we come together and say we have had enough of them, we will throw them out. Now then they send me threats. Because they know, say, their position, they shake. So make on no fear. When time come for election, make on everybody, make on participate. Make on stop to the run. Make on stop to the fear. Those directors of nursing, like the one when they data, when they do like say in emperor. When you come together, no, I'm not going to tell them what they're going to do. You are family members. All of them are adults. You get picking. The thing we hold on together in a nursing profession. Otherwise, if he see you for road, you're not going to let them talk stupid to you. But that say you be nurse and another person be your boss for nursing, not mean say you not get talk, you not fit talk. Respect yourself, respect them, but when it comes to professional issues, you are all equal. You should be treated with respect. Now the thing when I say make a tell on today, make on don't they fear anybody anymore. Nobody they use somebody head, they drink curry. So for the threat when then they send me, now because of honor, I just speak out for honor. Because before now, I'm not sure say many people feel they stick out their head the way they stick out. And the word when I they send, they hit their body. They hit their camp. Don't back down. Keep on agitating. Any bad spot in nursing, bring it to us. We will talk about it. We know they fear threats. They don't threaten me. I've been threatened so many times all my life. So this one, Gary. Make them bring their threat come. Make we see how they will carry them out. See, you won't shoot me because I speak the truth. Now that one will change the truth. You're not going to change anything now. You're not going to change anything. But the truth be say, before you reach where I did, you don't die. Because I don't do you anything. I don't plan evil against you. How you go come kill somebody when they talk through? Now yourself you go first kill. But this one, when issue this threat, I know them. And they are already being handled. But that one, not go make me not go sleep. I go go sleep. I go day fiercer. I go day more determined. I go day more inspired. But nurses, none go fail on a hand if on not fit follow direction and decide which way on a one make on a profession go. Because these people now why people them be. People when they selfish, then they greedy. They don't care about anything. They don't fit fight for now. Maybe I will cuckoo come contest for non-president. Because for real, I wish I can do it from a distance. I would do it. But I want some young people. Make them step forward. Young people when not they fear. Young people when won't make history. Young people who are hungry to serve and suffering. Make we be different people from what is taking place in Nigeria. The whole thing when they happen for Nigeria, don't enter inside nothing. Violence. Wayo GBT. The thing when my ear they hear since the past 3 days, the thing they turn my head for nurses. Now I make another play that nurses anthem again. I don't play it anymore. Because it's a ridicule of who we are. For real. For real. I can't believe what I have been hearing. The brigandage that nurses Some nurses have constituted themselves into nuisance. And I warn some of you young people, especially the young male nurses, some of you are so nasty, so ridiculous, so idiotic, so disrespectful. You don't even know. You just enter the profession. You don't know anything. You don't enter trap already. And when they tell you, you know they hear. You think say you know past anybody. You never see anything. Or you leak boot. It is another one will come catapult you ahead of those who should be ahead of you. No. Like I tell you, you need to pipe down and listen to those who have been through the grill. You are just starting. They sent some of you to attack me. Alright? How have you succeeded? No. I am a defender of yours. But you don't know, you are putting yourself in trap. Get up, stand up. Stand up for your right.
It is because most Nigerians don't understand that they are stakeholders in Nigeria and that they are part owners of Nigeria. That is why it is so easy for them to be in the chains of money bags and treasury looters like Atiku, Tinubu, and a host of others who are easily swayed to step forward to pay the bills when electoral gatherings are taking place. And the people hail them as the real men. These men and women have nothing to give in leadership, but they are investors who put in their money for return on investment. And unless and until Nigerians realize that they have a duty to be responsible for the growth, development, and the democratization of Nigeria, we will continue to be in the chains and shackles of these Sherlock politicians.
If they could crucify Jesus Christ, who am I that they were not threatened? Who am I? But you know, it is very clear. If you decide to be on the path of the truth, then you are going to be an enemy of a lot of people because you're going to be stepping on toes. Yes. You say, upon what? Upon speaking the truth. Because I speak the truth, that is why they want to silence me. That's why they want to shut me down. But unfortunately, they got the wrong person. I am a different nurse. I've been fighting for nurses, for the nursing profession, since my first day in school. I fought through the school. I fought through the clinical areas. I fought as a practitioner. And I'm back, trying to give back as a fighter. So I am not new to this business of fighting, but I need the soldiers who are committed, who are willing, who are ready, who will not do one thing this minute and do something else the next minute because they want to be seen as being good boys and girls. I never forget no way. This old man just can't be for rice. I never forget no way. They turned your backs on poor Google. So don't you forget no you, who you are and where you stand in the struggle. They got so much things to say. Yes, they got so much things to say. This thing is everlasting. It's got so much to say. So much things to say. So much things to say. I may not come to fight flesh and blood, but spiritual wickedness in high and low places.
So while they fight you down, stand firm and give Jack thanks and praises. Cause I and I don't expect to be justified by the laws of men. You see, prove that to prove of innocence. Go to wicked thing, they found them guilty. They got so much when the rain falls.
Yeah, so much things to say. You know, we've not come to fight just the flesh and blood, but against spiritual and political wickedness in high and low places. So when they find us guilty, the truth will stand firm and prove our innocence. So that is where I am. That is where I stand. Hey, my suggestion, my call, my appeal, passionate appeal to Nigerian nurses is for them to get together. Get together, set your differences aside, set religion aside, set tribal things aside. Come together as nurses. The language is nursing. It does not know tribe, it does not know religion. Come together, battle the darkness in your profession. You know it, right from your unit level to your state level. And to the national level, you will see things happening. I am very optimistic that we will overcome this darkness in the nursing profession in Nigeria. I am so optimistic. I have a promise to the nurses of Nigeria. I will never turn my back on you. I will never back down on the struggle to bring light into the profession. So do your own part as much as I'm doing mine. Just do your own part. You are the only one that can disappoint yourself. I am in a place where I don't need to be in Nigeria anymore to practice nursing. But I have put myself in a position to risk my life, put my resources, put my creative ingenuity, put my energy behind those who want to see the good of nursing in Nigeria. Yes, we coming close to the end of this program. Nigeria is our country. We must love and protect her, defend her even in her dysfunction. More importantly, we must recognize that we are nurses. Nurses don't do shady things. Nurses don't become cultists like some are becoming right now. Let us bring the light in us to illuminate the darkness that has eclipsed us and our profession for nearly 60 years. 2020 is the year of nurses. We should make it real. God bless you all, and God bless Nigeria. God bless the nurses of Nigeria, and God bless the nursing profession of Nigeria. That going forward, after this darkness, there will be light that will never be dimmed again. And nurses and the nursing profession shall be great. See you next Monday. Same time, same station, same presenter, Smart Madu Ajaja, on the Nurses Arise program on the Nightingale Radio Station, broadcasting live from Houston, Texas, United States of America. You take care.
Yeah.